that is the genera of hyphomycetes. It is a book which even a layman should possess just for the beauty of it, beauty of its illustrations and the contents and their presentation in a style which will cheer up even an artist. The reason is immense amount of efforts have been consolidated in the book called Genera of Hyphomycetes, and it has become a gold standard, I believe, for taxonomist, ecologist and biologist in other fields also. While I was going through the book which we have in the library, Goa University, it's advertised that you cannot send it by ordinary post and all because it weighs more than 3 kilograms. That is the description of the book, that book weighs 3 kilograms, has almost 1000 pages, and it's not that easy to import it and possess it. But what is important about the book is at the end of that, after you actually understand that book as a creative production, at the end of that I just could see this personality, and I thought he is Socrates of mycology for me. I mean, his entire life and work, it's a Socratian tribute, because if you ask me which is the greatest name in philosophy, that is Socrates. And he also, like Jacob Bronowski once remarked in his the book Ascent of Man, when people are confused about diverse interests of intellectuals, scholars, Jacob Bronowski in Ascent of Man made a very interesting statement when he defined art and he defined science. Here is a man who brought both interests together in genera of hyphomycetes. You can feel the weight of that impulse, that passion. And that is, Bronowski said, all art is synthesis and all science is analysis. I salute you, because in the genera of hyphomycetes, you have proven Jacob Bronowski true by bringing art and science of mycology together, sir. We salute you here before you take to the stage, before you take to the mic. All the people of Goa welcome you here, and we are looking forward for a very interesting session to follow. And after that, I will be conducting a small question answer session. We have constraint of time. After that, the vote of thanks will be proposed by Dr. Bernard Rodriguez. So now I leave the stage open to our esteemed speaker, and I think it is going to be a historic and memorable evening, a feast of knowledge for you, and all of us are looking forward to your presentation. Thank you very much. May I request the president to please escort the other guests to the auditorium.